Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to Hot Sugar Showroom. So today's video is going to be a little bit different from my other recent videos. They have been more about life subjects, things I feel that we all could work on or improve on personally as human beings on this earth navigating through life. Well, this video will be targeted more towards business owners or those who are interested in owning a business, those who have business in mind or want to collaborate with others, and just teaching them a little bit of what I know. So this video specifically will talk more about branding and finding your target audience. Many may not know, but I am a social media manager, which means I run the pages of other small businesses, Instagram pages, sometimes their Twitter and Facebook as well. Meaning I post content for them, I schedule content for them, I create content for them, and I'm responsible for making sure it gets out there at the right time, to the right people with the right hashtags, etc. So I'm just gonna give you a few tips basically about branding or about your business, about marketing, and about social media. I would say when it comes to branding your business, it's very, very important. A lot of people don't understand how important it is to brand your business. Branding your business, if I give you an example, meaning when you see the yellow arch, you recognize that as McDonald's, you recognize that as the hamburgers and the french fries and whatever else has evolved from it. If you see the redhead little girl, you recognize that as Wendy's. You know that that is the place that also sells fast food, burgers, french fries, and now even breakfast. So over time, yes, your business can evolve. Yes, it can add new things. Yes, it can become something that it didn't start off as. But you have to start your business off as something recognizable by people. When they see this, they want to know that is you and what about you. So such as 7-Eleven, when you see the big old 7, in the circle with the multicolors, the green and the red and the yellow, you'll know, okay, this is normally a 7-Eleven store. You can see it far away and you'll recognize the brand. And when I say that, what do you recognize about brands? You recognize the colors, like I mentioned, you'll recognize the yellow arch, which is the color. Also, you'll notice the shape of the M and the arch, the golden arch, as they sometimes call it. When it comes to 7-Eleven, you'll recognize the 7, you'll recognize the green always, mainly a red, I believe. You'll always recognize that as the brand colors for 7-Eleven, the brand colors for McDonald's. Another big brand, popular, let's even think, such as clothing-wise. With Burberry, you always notice the print. Everyone knows the print. For Burberry, you'll see, okay, that's Burberry by the print. It has the striped print. And so with many businesses, they have made their brand or their businesses, let's say Polo, you'll recognize the logo for that. Lacoste, you'll recognize the alligator. Like, there are certain images in your mind that when someone mentions this brand, it automatically is recognized as this. That's the place for that. So with your brand, you have to be efficient in deciding what you want to create. And you have to know from the beginning what you want your business to be recognized as. If you want your business to be a happy place, yellow is a color of happiness and brightness. Yes, that color is associated with, this is the happy place. This is where kids will love to go, adults as well. When it's a more serious thing, when it may be business or more professional, you may notice darker colors such as a black or a white or a navy blue or brown. There are certain colors associated with certain things. And all you have to do, when trying to create your brand and trying to create your brand colors, is to Google a brand color chart. You'll Google the chart and you'll see a circle and it'll tell you the moods of each color, what they bring to people, what they mean. Like, they, like, purple is often recognized as a regal color, of a color of royalty. And when you, green is associated with money. So if you have a financial business, you normally would see some type of green in the logo or the branding. And so I just want you to take the time to really Google the colors already associated with your brand if you already began one. See if it fits for the brand that you currently have or that you want to get out there that you're trying to market. And or if not, begin to decide on what colors it is that would fit your brand and how you can reshape them to still get people to notice this is your brand if you already have an established audience, but this is where we're growing to. This is how we have transformed. You can change over time. Yes, you can change your logo, the images, etc., but you have to keep some consistency so people are able to say, when I see this, I know this is her brand. And such as, okay, with logos, often people get logos and graphic images confused. I've done it myself. For many years growing up, I created what I thought were logos for many business ideas that I've had over the years. I've created hundreds and thousands of them, and I've thought, okay, this is my logo. But sometimes the logo was a graphic image, and I had to be taught from other people that were in the marketing business or in branding businesses or consulting businesses for small businesses who would say, no, that's not a logo, that's a graphic image, or that can be used for this, this, and this in your business. Oftentimes, when it comes to a logo, if you want your logo to be transferable on a product, when I say that, meaning it is able to be transformed onto something and to be seen clear and visually. I'm going to give you a quick example. This candy-coated Knight's Cup, I don't know if you can see this clear, but with their brand, they had to be very specific in keeping just the letters and the font and the format of these letters, if you can see that clear, so that when it is transferred from just being a logo onto a physical item, such as a coffee cup, that you'll be able to see it clear. With many businesses and brands, they have created these logos, like oftentimes, a few years ago, especially, everyone became obsessed with glitter logos. I'm not going to lie, I wanted one myself. I'm like, oh my gosh, I love glitter. I love the sparkles. I love the shine. But it is not the best idea for every brand, because if every boutique has a glitter logo, how will yours stand out? If every hair reseller has a sparkly logo, how will your brand stick out? You have to make your brand recognizable. You have to make your brand stick out. And if it looks exactly like everyone else's, it won't. And so it also won't be transferable. If you're thinking about long term for your brand and you're thinking, okay, I want to get this printed onto clothing, I want to get this printed onto tags, I want to get this printed onto t-shirts or lanyards, or I want to get it printed on keychains, or I want to get it printed on photo cards or whatever you want it to get printed on, you have to think about it being cost efficient, because if you have many, many colors in your logo and you're transferring it to art, it costs. All of the different colors you may include, the images, say you have an image attached to your logo, you may want to use the graphics for your logo for online. This is what I suggested to someone recently. She had two amazing logos, but one had a graphic attached, which was like an image or a picture or an item of something. And it's great to go with your logo, but it oftentimes, if it doesn't fit in the specific lettering of it, I would say use it for online purposes to promote your product. But when transferring to physical products or going out to promote, I would use the lettering, because oftentimes when you have all those images or the graphics attached to it, that doesn't capture our attention automatically. The word alone sometimes does. Like even with KFC, you'll see the white man and the hair like that and the suit almost look, but automatically the letters KFC being very large will capture your attention, you know, first, such as CVS. You'll automatically see the big red CVS, simple as can be, and yet we will always recognize that brand. Even though it does say CVS, we'll always recognize that brand, we'll always understand who this brand is and what it comes from and where it's, you know, where it's going. So I just say that with your brand colors are very important. Pay attention to the colors that you use when you go out to promote your brand, whether you're doing vending, sponsoring, whatever you're doing, be sure to be consistent in your colors. Like a hair care brand I work with, they always were consistent with the pink and the white. You always have to use the same colors for the most part when you're going out. It would be nice to that you represent in your colors, that your brand, the logo, the stand, the banners, the flyers you pass out, your business cards all have the same look or design to some extent. It could have some aesthetics be different, but for the most part, it should have your brand colors or your image attached to it, so that when people get your card and they already were at the event and they seen your banners or your stand, they'll go home and they'll look at the car and they'll be like, oh, I remember this one, because it'll start to click. Yeah, they had all that purple and that white. Like, you have to have certain colors that capture people's attention. And please don't put a whole bunch of, like, all dark colors together, like, and all bright colors together. Like, be very specific. If you have to go to someone who's a little bit better in designing than you, allow them to speak for you or speak to you. And yes, it is best to purchase a logo. I know a lot of the times people don't want to invest in one. They're like, I can go on this app and make it myself. There are plenty of free apps to make a logo yourself. You can even go on Canva for free and create a logo. Yes, you can. If you're starting off and you're young, sure. And if you want to type up some letters and you want to start your business, sure. But as time progresses, as your business grows, it is best to invest in a logo so that you can have the vector image of it, so that you can have it without the background. Because oftentimes people don't have their image, their logo, without the background, and they're not able to transfer it onto products or onto flyers as easily. So please make sure your graphic designer is giving you the best version of your logo as well. Sometimes we go to the smaller outlets and we don't ask for what we want. If you need a logo, there are sites like Fiverr, but as well as there are many businesses, small businesses on Facebook and Instagram who design logos. If you need one, just ask and I'll search and I'll be able to refer you to someone, because I've ran into many. I just can't think of their names all right now, and I should have been prepared, but I'm not. There are so many great logo designers. And logos range from, like, very affordable prices. There are some as low as, like, $35 to maybe $100. And there are some that will get even more expensive if you have a high brand of $500. But they really take their time in designing a logo that can be transferred onto an ice cream truck or onto an physical brick-and-mortar location. Like, there are some that can really go high-end. And it just depends on where your brand is and in its transformation level. Like, there are levels. You start off, your logo may look like one thing. As time progresses, it may look like a whole nother. Example, I have an online boutique, which I haven't been working on, but I will get back to it. Trust me, it's coming. And at first I named it Superstar Style, which was a hot mess. I was young and just naming it, thinking everything is superstar this, superstar that, and style, and it's cute, and it's this. And as I got older, I'm just like, that is not, no. Like, that's not cute. I don't like it. It's not, no. And so as I grew, I learned Misfit. And Misfit is spelled M-S-F-I-T, not M-I-S-F-I-T. My Misfit is M-S-F-I-T. That's my boutique's name that I have not been working on. And I've also transformed the logo. At the beginning, it was full of color. I love color. Color is beautiful. But also, I had to think of my brand's longevity and where I wanted to see it go. And so now I've transformed the logo into more of a black and white, Misfit, bold, just lettering. No image attached, none of that. And so, yeah, be very careful when it comes to your brand. Just be very specific on what it is that you want as far as your colors, as far as the design. Even when it comes to your business cards, don't invest in something you don't believe in yourself. If you're not really sure about it, you don't love it. I've done it 1,000 times before, so you won't be alone. I've purchased so many different things, websites, business cards, flyers, logos, and I haven't loved them all. And at the time, I just was like, oh yeah, that works. And then as time progressed and I look at it more and more, I'm like, no, this doesn't fit the brand. It doesn't go with what I want or where I'm going. And I'm getting older and things are transforming from being a teenager looking at businesses to being a young woman. And so I'm just trying to give you a few key tools or tips that are essential to starting your business or your brand when it comes to branding. Marketing, this all ties in, because when people see your brand, they see you, they see the story behind it, and you want people to be able to understand where you're coming from. Without you telling the story, they should look at your page, your Instagram page. It's very important to have it lined up in a certain order. And I'm not saying it has to be the three images the same on every pattern. I'm not saying it has to have this big, huge blocked graphic. But what I am saying is that it's very important to pay attention to the aesthetic of your Instagram, because there are so many Instagram pages out today, so many businesses on Instagram, that yours has to stand out. Your bio, which is at the top under your picture, has to have something capturing, whether it's a capturing logo or slogan. Like, have something that'll make people want to come back to your page and be like, what is she talking about? I wonder why she said this. And they'll want to know more of the story behind your brand. Also be professional in it. Have your website. There is a link for it. There is a space for it in your bio. Business pages for Instagram and Facebook. Have your websites link there. If you don't have a professional website at the moment, use at least Linktree for the time being. Linktree is free. You can promote all of your different platforms on there. Someone can go to your Linktree / whatever your page name is and be able to find different links to different accounts and be able to go to whatever platform of yours that they want and support you. So please have your Linktree and your bio at the minimum if you're a business or a brand. And I said the bio, make sure it has something capturing, whether a slogan, whether a saying, whether it's something unique about you. I don't know if you got three legs instead of two, like put that in your bio so people want to come back and be like, okay, they got three legs, not two. Like whatever it is that will capture people's attention, have them come back and be honest about it. Don't just make up something horrendous that has nothing to do with you or your brand. Then no, but something that really fits, something that you really can stand by. Put it in your bio. Make sure it's capturing. Make sure you put your website, your image. For a business, I would always suggest mainly to put your logo as your business Instagram page photo, your profile picture. That's what I would suggest because I like pages that are clean and neat. That's the way I look. When I first go on Instagram, I don't want to see some picture in an outfit that may be one of the outfits on your boutique. And if it's not very clear and sharp and fresh and I can see the entire look like beautifully and I just see part of the top and half of the skirt, I'm going to be agitated. I'm going to think that you don't invest in your brand. You don't know what you're doing. There's not someone behind your page. And it's not going to make me want to check it out. But if I see a fresh, clean logo and then I click on the page and then there's these beautiful images of these clothing, I'll be happy to support. And just for boutique owners or people that sell hair or anybody with a product that has a business Instagram page, if you have more than 10,000 followers, you are able to add your link so that when the image is up there, someone can swipe up to go to your website, swipe up to purchase the product, or they can click on it and be able to be tagged to your specific website or linked page. So just a heads up in case you don't know that. 10K or more followers, if you're not there, I can help you get there. But 10K or more followers on your page, on your business page, you can link the product. You can link the product. I said bio, your Instagram image. Okay, highlights. There are highlights at the top of our Instagram pages now. Highlights are bubbled at the top. You'll see several of them on many people's pages. They can include videos and pictures. They are normally videos and pictures that are added to your Instagram story. As we know, Instagram story deletes within 24 hours. It does the same on Facebook. It deletes normally within 24 hours, sometimes a little longer. And so on Instagram, when you automatically go to your page, your highlights are at the top. It is what people can click on automatically when they come to your page and see and view. And so if you have images of your products, places that you've vendored, events, sponsorships, or things that you've done, places you've spoken, all of these videos, all of these things can be included at your highlights. And someone could click on it and see things of you reading out your poetry at an event if you're a poet. Selling your pieces if you sell pieces. Like, there are great things that we can just click on really fast and see at the top. And it's just an amazing way to limit the content because your page could be filled with thousands of pictures if you're a brand that's been up for years. But then your highlights can have little special moments that are highlights of your business or your brand. Say you were sponsored in this magazine or featured. You can have that image of that in your highlights. When posting on Instagram, it's very important to include hashtags. Hashtags are a major way for other people who do not follow you, like your page, or support you already to see your content. If they click on a specific hashtag, your content can be shown. But it is very important to not use hashtags that already have millions of views because often your content will be flushed. It will be at the bottom. If you're not already an influencer, if you're not already someone with a large following, if you're not already someone who's very popular, your content will be flushed. So it's important to only use hashtags that may have 100,000, 10,000, 20,000, 30,000 posts under it so that you can still be somewhat seen or be relevant in the content. Maybe even less. It'll be better, but it's hard to find them because hashtags are, they are being used, trust me. And there are different ways to use them. I could go into so much depth about all of these different things, like brand colors, brands, marketing, all of that. But I'm going to just sum it up really quick for this video get too long and I go too in depth. When it comes to your brand and marketing it, social media is a great platform for today. Instagram, Facebook, don't listen to, you know, people who may have lived in another age time or lifetime where they may be like, oh, but social media is irrelevant. It doesn't help you. It has helped grow many brands. Have you heard of Super Scent? Her brand has grown tremendously from social media. Have you heard of her best friend, the real BB Judy, who has the Miracle Drops? And Super Scent has the Crayon Case. Their brands have grown dramatically off of social media, but they use it properly. There is a way to include your personal life, which they have done on their pages because people are personally invested in them. There is a way, and you are your brand. Remember that you are your brand. So when people see you, yes, they do see your brand. Often, unless your face will be completely hidden from the brand totally. There is a way to market on social media. There is a way, but I'm not saying that you don't still have to market in person, still don't have to talk to people about your business or your brand, interact, have real conversations, you do all of that. But it is very well a way to have a business and a brand thriving off of social media. So this is my quick little review in branding and marketing for your business starting off. So like, comment, and subscribe. As always, High Sugar Showroom.